tied with rhymes of how the war at last died, and repeat them 100 times. Each damn time I shall cry. Lines written and translated by the Dutch-American poet Leo Vroman. Vroman was Jewish and in 1940 managed to escape the approaching evil and thus survived the war. He at least. Today, we are remembering all the people who did not survive the Nazi regime of annihilation. Today, on this day, the 27th of January, the day designated by the United Nations as International Holocaust Remembrance Day. The United Nations that was set up in response to the horrors of the Second World War. Here too, in our UN city, The Hague, this past year, we marked the 75th anniversary of that organization and reflected on what has been achieved in 75 years. In the field of human rights, for instance, or international criminal law, which occupies such a prominent place in my city, The Hague, as the international city of peace and justice. 80 years ago, during the Second World War, that was far from true. A regime that despised humanity was installed here at the time. More than 12,000 of The Hague's Jewish residents fell victim to that regime. Men and women, children and seniors alike. And I'm standing here by the monument that commemorates one of the greatest evils ever to befall The Hague, the murder of its Jewish citizens. At the start of the war, The Hague was home to the second largest Jewish community in our country, in the Netherlands, after Amsterdam. And by 1945, that community had been largely wiped out. Opposite where I'm standing now, there is a square named after The Hague's chief rabbi, Isaac Maarse, who was also murdered. And there's a monument on the square which commemorates the Jewish children who died. It's a most suitable place for it, because it was here that one of the schools designated by the occupiers as a Jewish school once stood. Here, the children were taught reading, writing, and arithmetic, even as the classrooms were becoming more empty by the day, right until the bitter end. A handful of class photos from the Jewish primary school taken during the time still remain. From the few pictorial records we have of the persecution of Jews in The Hague, these photos are among the most heartbreaking. We don't know the names of the children in the photos and about what happened to them. We can only fear the worst. It's up to us and the future generations to keep memory of those terrible times alive and always to strive for peace, freedom and justice. The history of Nazism and the occupation of the Netherlands just shows us how insidiously, sometimes even imperceptibly, the rule of law can be undermined. How people can be stripped of their rights, one by one, and relegated to second-class citizens. Even now, 75 years later, we still need to be on our guard to combat all forms of anti-Semitism. Not look away, but stand up for our fellow citizens and remain vigilant when it comes to freedom and the rule of law, both at home and further away.